Okay, here is the Rolex Submariner date. As it called it, is the 11-16-10 LN. And why I choose this, the date, from the no date Rolex Submariner? I want first to say that the first Submariner didn't have the date. So if someone want to buy the no date, it's something like a retro style to remember this old-fashioned, how to say now, Rolexes, to remember that. But for me, it was important to have the date. First of all, I just want to see the date, not just asking someone or seeing my mobile phone. You just turn, you see the date, and that's it. From there, in my opinion, someone can recognize a Rolex from the magnified glass. How? There. From meters away, you can understand that you are 99% sure that this guy is wearing a Rolex when you see the magnified. From hundreds away, you are. So for me, it's something like that you can recognize absolutely that this watch is a Rolex. From me. The Submariner date costs, I think, 1,500 euros more than the no date. But from someone who will give that kind of money, he won't see that, the money. And I think it's very cool that you have a very nice watch, and except of seeing the time, you can see in the date. And for me, that's very important. I believe it's very nice, and the no date, without the magnified glass, without the date here, for me it was very simple. Watch, it hasn't have something special, something it just a regular watch. I believe that the date is something that if I want to buy Rolex, definitely I would choose the date on it, definitely. This is the reason I bought the date from the no date. And thanks for watching again.